Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We are back with a video related to Saturn. It's been many months and maybe years that I made a video on Saturn. And somebody had asked me recently, what is the easiest remedy for somebody who is running a difficult time during Saturn Antardasha, Mahadasha, or Sade Sati, or any transit of Saturn, either it's from Moon or Ascendant or Sun or Venus or Natal Saturn, Saturn return, or dreaded conjunctions like Saturn Mars, Sangharsh Yog, Shrapit Yog, Saturn Rahu conjunction, Vish Yog, Sun Moon, sorry, Saturn Moon, and what is Sun Saturn conjunction name? I don't know. So any yoga of Saturn, if you are under. And if you feel that life's becoming very, very, very difficult, you are not able to handle the energies, the challenges, and you're not sure of the outcomes, then yes, this is something which we shall discuss today. And it's very simple, but yet not that simple. But at least we should try, right? If it is there in our karma, we shall get it. All right. There you go. So, what is the easiest remedy for Saturn? So, what is Saturn actually? For newcomers, Saturn represents hard work, discipline, doing things even if you don't like. Daily work. Saturn is the Karaka for the sixth house, which is the house of daily work. And sixth house shows the weaknesses which pull us down, basically, which gives us a feeling that we are not able to do things even if we want to do them. Okay, so that's what the sixth house is. Then he's the Karaka for the eighth house. What is the eighth house? Eighth house shows the reversals which we get in life, the unexpected events. Okay, so wherever Saturn is sitting, you will get these feelings of weakness or lethargy or reversals, basically unexpected untoward events of in your life. Okay. And then it is the Karaka for the 12th house, which is the house of losses. So therefore, many people say they have a lot of losses during Saturn's Dasha or Sade Sati or whatever it is. And I have already made videos on Sade Sati detailed series, so I'll put it at the end of the video. You can watch, and I'll also put the other Saturn videos. If you're interested, you can watch. And I will also make a dedicated video for Saturn remedies, all right? And as usual, if you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your Saturn, then you can go down to the website below in the description section. All right. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him even when there is Sade Sati. So, and these are the things which Saturn represents. And He rules the 10th house and the 11th house of name, fame, power, position. I mean, in the original the Kalpurush Kundali, which is Aries ascendant. So that means to get these things you must cross through the Industhanas. That is what it means. Okay, so now we have to understand Saturn is always downward facing. Okay, so there are planets which are like, you know, forward or they are downward. So in layman's language, you can understand what is the feeling which you get when you are running the dasha of that planet. Okay. Now, dashas are very intricate, and we should not judge by, okay, Saturn dasha, it will be bad. Okay, I'm not saying that. If Saturn is well placed in your horoscope, the end result of the dasha is good. The end result, I don't mean the journey. The journey of Saturn is always painful, which means there's a lot of stress and struggle and anxiety which is involved. Okay, whichever horoscope you are, it's Yog Karak, exalted, debilitated, Hindustan, Mool Trikon, whichever house, I don't care. It is ultimately Saturn. So the journey is never easy for Saturn. Okay. But if Saturn is badly placed, the end is also terrible. And if Saturn is well placed, the end is beautiful. And that's why they say, all's well that ends well. Ant bhala to sab bhala. So therefore, Saturn is downward facing. You know, that word is there in the scriptures. What is the meaning of the word downward facing? Downward facing means you feel that. You need to know everything actually, and you feel that if you don't master every bit of it, you won't be happy. Or you need to put so much effort that everything matters. So whenever you are running Saturn, you can check sometimes. Many people tell me, "Oh, everything has come up together." Why does that happen? Because when Saturn, you are running Saturn, then what happens is you kind of get above it and you are trying to see everything from the top. So therefore you see everything, all the good and bad, how to connect the dots. Okay. So now this is very good if you want to settle everything, but there's one disadvantage of this. What is this? It's not a disadvantage, I would say it's a shortcoming basically, or it is something which we need to master. Is Saturn gives us familiarity with the details of our life, but Saturn doesn't give us a vision. What do you mean by vision? Vision means what will I achieve at the end of settling all this? Suppose your career is not settled and Saturn is related to your career houses, then you want to settle your career, but then where do you settle? What do? Where do you go? These are the things which we may not know when Saturn Dasha is there, okay, or Sade Sati, or even if Saturn transits your ascendant or sun, natal sun, I mean, okay, these things can happen. So therefore, what is that one thing which everybody should understand about Saturn? We have to understand that the biggest remedy for Saturn is we should have the right guidance in life, okay. If we do not have right guidance, then what happens is we are so much caught up in the technicalities that we forget the purpose. And who is the guide? It is Jupiter, actually. Your ninth lord of your horoscope, according to your ascendant and Jupiter, these two always shows guides and gurus, okay? So therefore, if you are running Mahadasha of Saturn and Antardasha of Jupiter or the ninth lord, then it's a very good time to get guidance, all right? Jupiter's Antardasha is the last Antardasha of Saturn Mahadasha, okay? So that's like saying you did everything and then at the last, the guru comes and tells you, oh, oops, this is where you need to end up finally, okay? Or suppose your ninth lord is Venus or Sun or Mercury or whoever, you know, then that Antardasha can behave like the guru sometimes, okay? So therefore, you have to understand that what does the guru do? What happens when you get right guidance? You get a vision, actually. So what happens when you get vision? You understand where you should land up ultimately. Because many times people tell me that they are working hard always during Saturn's Dasha. But then, if working hard alone would give success to everybody, then everybody would be like, you know, super duper bumper successful. No, it doesn't work like that. What determines you will be successful or not? Your success, no, I'm not talking of career success, success in any area of your life, determines if your efforts are consistently put in the right direction. Imagine you take a car and you go front, then you go back, you go right, left, then you come back, go here. So then ultimately you will be at the same place. So that's what happens when Saturn's period comes. You keep hearing in YouTube and, you know, all these articles and all these horrible things about Saturn. Work hard, work hard, work hard, work like a donkey, work like an animal. But it doesn't work, actually, because there are so many people who I know, they tell me that, oh, I've worked like anything. I worked like a machine, like a robot during Saturn, but still I was not successful. Why? Because your efforts were not geared in the right direction, in the proper direction. Okay. So therefore, during Saturn, you must go and seek guidance from your seniors and your gurus, because they will tell you how should you behave stepwise. So if you are planning to go for higher education, like for example, when I came to Germany here for my master's in University of Göttingen, I had a mentor. He was my elder brother's friend. He studied here in TU Dresden. Okay. So he was a very beautiful mentor. He always helped me in getting to know how to do things here. Okay. And that's an example. Even in my spiritual life, when I started off with my journey in Chennai at SRM University, then I met so many gurus and so many guides and so many counselors. They helped me out. So without the help of all these people, in whichever area of life, I would be nowhere, actually. Maybe I would be just running in one place, like a like running in the treadmill. Okay, so therefore, you have to understand that just working hard is not enough. You have to work hard in a way that your efforts are summing up and you are moving forward in that same direction. Because if you do not have a vision, then you may feel that although you are ready to work hard, but you don't know where will you land up. And that gives you insecurity. So they say Saturn is the significator of insecurity. Why? Because you work like as if you are headless during Saturn, and that's the problem. Because then you become double. It's like a chain cycle. You see what happens. You get some pressure, then you work hard. Okay? Then you are in anxiety. What will happen? Then you to get rid of that anxiety, you do not seek a vision. You again work hard. Then again you are in anxiety, again you become insecure that last time I put so much effort, even now why am I not seeing results? Then you become further insecure, then you work 10 times more, and then you become more anxious, you become more insecure. So it's like a very dreaded cycle when Saturn comes. So therefore, please do not waste your life just by working hard like donkeys, as they say, he's working like a donkey. I've seen people, they work hard even more than animals. I've seen even more than a donkey, they work sometimes, but still there is no result. Okay, so the guide or the guru can exactly tell you where you should. So the guide or the guru, the mentor, gives you landmarks. Okay, that is the most important duty. So the guru tells you, you are here, these are your landmarks, these things you will get in the journey, this is how you should walk, this is where you should walk, and this is where you should land up ultimately. So suppose you have a career goal, Saturn is linked with your 10th house, 10th lord or sun or Mercury, then you may have a lot of career issues. So then what happens is you get a mentor, and then you express to your mentor that, my dear sir, my dear madam, this is what I want to do in my career. So can you please tell me? Can you please help me? Go ahead. I want to achieve this in the next 5 years or 1 years, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. And then the mentor will tell you, oh, look, I have already walked the path which you have walked, and I feel this path is not good. If you want to achieve this goal in 5 years, maybe you may need 10 years, or maybe you are walking too slow. You may walk it in 1 year itself. So therefore, the mentor should know who you are, your situation, your strengths and your weaknesses. And then the mentor should suggest you that where you should be working hard. Okay? And by that, you will see that your life has totally changed actually. So therefore, before you complain about Saturn Mahadasha, Antardasha, I see it all the time. Complaining, complaining, complaining. Sare Sati Mahadasha, Antardasha. Please ask yourself this question. You are working hard, but do you know where is your goal? What is your destination? What are your landmarks? Do you know? I'm very sure you would not, because if you would have seen the landmarks, then you would have, your insecurity would have reduced, because you would have understood that, okay, now this is where I was 5 years back. Now I'm here, and then after 5 years I'll be here. So seeing milestones or landmarks gives you reassurance that yes, I am on the right track. So milestones are very important, and because we have not traversed that path, it might be difficult for us to assume those milestones. Okay? Now we can have our own milestones depending on what we think is right and wrong, but then the mentor or the guru or the guide can actually tell you, is it realistic or not? Okay? So therefore, please invest your money in getting a mentor. Yes, because if you do not get, then what happens is you are running in the same place again and again. It's not going to help you. Okay. So therefore, whichever domain you are, try to connect with those people who are successful in that area. So if you want to learn astrology, for example, then try to find some astrologer who is successful in teaching astrology within your town. Okay. Don't search on YouTube, it's not good. Search in your town. It's very easy to write in comments below, be my mentor. No, it doesn't work like that. Go and find out in your town or in your state or in your city. Do the hard work. Don't keep sitting and watching movies. It won't get you anywhere. If you want to, many people tell me that they want to go to US or Europe to do masters from India. Well, then you should go to linkedin.com and find somebody who is ready to mentor you. go and tell them that I am ready to offer you this much charge monthly. 1 hour we will have a conversation. Please guide me, or if you have an initial process, or how much would you like to charge. So then they also are very happy to mentor you, because most of the times people think mentorship is, you know, it's like for no money. Then that's why I know so many of my friends, so many people here, they can become the best mentors I know, but then they are reluctant because they know nobody will pay their money. Okay. So next time you approach somebody in Facebook or in LinkedIn or in YouTube, make sure you ask them how much will they charge you, because that mentorship is just like any other service. You are giving your time. So that person deserves to be paid. Okay. So now which mentor should you select? Well, that is your responsibility. So you can check. So suppose you want to get good guidance regarding how to be a good programmer, because I am from IT sector, so I'm giving these examples. So then you can see what kind of projects that person has done, whatever, what is there in that person's resume, or not resume, but practical projects, what that person has done, or you can at least talk to that person once, or is the person's current position something which you want to achieve? Okay. Suppose the person is vice president of a company, or is a senior software developer, for example, then are you also aiming for that, or are you aiming for, you know, finance sector, data science, or big data, cloud, whatever it is? Or if you want to do MBA, then try to find somebody. Okay, so that will save you hundreds and thousands of hours of effort, actually. Okay, and that you will not realize now, that you will realize after 5-6 years. Like, for example, now I realize if my brother's friend would not have been there here to guide me, then I don't know how I would have got to understand these things. You know, it's very difficult here coming and doing master's. Difficult, not the education part, but overall, you know, settling, learning German, and getting a job. And it's a very challenging process, the overall thing. Okay. I mean, individually, they are not very challenging. But overall, it takes a toll on your body and your mental health, because you are all alone here. Okay. Hardly you will have friends here. So this is just an example. So sometimes the journey which we take, you are planning to open your own business, or your married life is not good, find a marriage counselor or somebody within your family who has had successful marriages. Okay. Or you want to elevate spiritually, then try to find some guide who can give you guidance spiritually. Okay. Your Shiksha Guru, and finally you take Diksha ultimately. So this applies to everything. You want to improve your health, go and hire a fitness trainer, actually. Otherwise, it's very difficult, or a yoga trainer, or at least go and enroll yourself in a course. Okay. So when you do that, then what happens is you will get a vision, and then you keep working hard 20 hours like humans or donkeys. It doesn't matter. But if you claim to work like donkeys just for the sake of working, I'm sorry, you may not be successful. You may be, if that's there in your karma, or if you're lucky. But I have seen 99% of the people, they work hard in Saturn's period. The only problem is they don't know what they are doing. They're just doing because they are supposed to do. No, it should not be like that. Okay. There you go. That is the easiest remedy for Saturn. And if you do this, you are within Saraswati or anything, you will see things will vanish, actually, because you will get a vision. Then you know where I should go. Okay. Don't ruin your life. Don't confuse yourself. Don't work hard like donkeys. It is not going to give you any results. Okay. Wish you all the best for your Saturn Dasha, Mahadasha, Saraswati, Antara Dasha, Pratyantara, whatever it is. All right. As usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And I put the other videos for Saturn and Saraswati here. If you're interested, you could always watch them. And yes, if you want a consultation from me, you can go to the website down. And what is there with you? All the time, just look to him and you will find him.